So in this video, I'm just going to talk about the power sockets in a Tesla and why you've got to be very careful what you plug into them. So what's prompted me to make this video is I've just seen a post on Facebook and someone plugged in a compressor, a little tyre pump, into their Tesla when they were on the side of the road trying to sort out a puncture and it stopped working. And they were asking, is it because these outlets are now 16 volt on the later Teslas? Because if you don't know, Tesla now no longer fit 12 volt auxiliary batteries up front, they fit 16.5 volt lithium-ion batteries. So I've done a video on the channel already about the Towbar electrics there on the back and what the voltage is on that, and I've tested that and that's 12.78 volts and this car has got the 16 volt lithium-ion battery. So what I'm going to do is measure the voltage on the two power outlets on the car and see if that voltage is stepped down like they've done for the Towbar. 90% of the viewers of this channel are not subscribed. I'm sorry to ask, but it would help greatly if you would. Just press the subscribe button. It's free and it shows YouTube you like this sort of vehicle related content. If you want to be notified when new videos are released, please click on the bell button also. Thank you, it really helps more than you would imagine. So if we look at the user manual for the Tesla Model Y, it says that after November 2021, the power outlets will be 16 volt and you need to make sure any devices you plug into them will support 16 volts. And it also says the vehicle must be awake to be delivering power to those sockets, of course. You can pause the video if you want to read this. So what I'm going to do is just keep the climate on so it keeps the vehicle awake. And then I'm going to measure the power from the socket in the back, which is a bit awkward because you have to climb in the boot. I need to tilt that towards me so I can see what that says. 15.26. And the other outlet is in the storage compartment in the center console. And again, this is 15.26 volts. So it is strange when you've got a Tesla with a tow bar. They're going to the effort of dropping the voltage down on the tow bar electrics there to 12.5 volts, but leaving your 12 volt power outlets at 15.5 volts. So what that means is any accessory you plug into the power outlets on the Tesla, you just got to make sure that it's suitable to run at 16 volts. So this then raises the issue, what about tyre compressors? You may have seen on the channel, I've got quite a few videos now about puncture repair kits and the spare wheel here, and I carry everything to sort myself out. And down here I have got a couple of tyre pumps, compressors. So what I've got to do is make sure those are suitable to run on the power outlets on the Tesla. So if you want to know more about what puncture equipment to carry in your vehicle, and also about the space saver spare wheel, and how I've mounted it under the floor here, I'll put links to all those videos in the video description below, but they're all on the channel. So I've got a compressor here which came out of my Model S actually. It says Tesla there, but that's just a sticker on it. So you need to look on the back somewhere and see if you can see the input voltage and make sure your accessory can support 16 volts. But there's nothing on this one, so let's try it. So I'll plug that in there. And I'm just going to leave that running for a few minutes. Crikey, that is a noisy compressor. So that seems fine. And what I've said in other videos, you need to test all this equipment. If you're carrying puncture repair kits, the spare wheel, the jack and the brace, you need to make sure it all works with your vehicle and you know how to use it. So practice at home before you're in that dangerous situation on the side of the road. So you know how to make it all work, you know how to repair your puncture or change your wheel, and then you can get moving quickly, get out of that dangerous situation. And the same goes for testing your compressor, but I'd forgotten that bit because I could have been in that situation where I had a puncture, was trying to repair it, got all the gear, but my compressor possibly wouldn't have supported 16 volts. But anyway, that one does. I've got another one in the slime kit, which I'm going to take out and check what the input voltage is on that, but I'm sure it'll be okay. But it's worth checking this stuff beforehand, before you're in that situation where you really are reliant on it. Of course, the same goes with anything you're plugging into this front or rear accessory socket, whether that's dash cams, chargers, fridge units or whatever. If you've got the newer Tesla with a lithium battery up front, you need to make sure that these accessories are happy being powered at 16 volts, or in this case 15.3 volts versus 12 volts. So that'll do. If you found this video useful, as always, please do click the thumbs up, because that really does help. Do subscribe to the channel. If you want to see other videos on the Tesla Model Y, there's a link below to a playlist where you can see those. Okie doke, I'll see you on the next one.